Hey guys, this is Ben, and I am happy to be here today. With the street food pro Mark. With the what is it? It's the Great American Hot Dog Stand. Oh yeah, street food pro right there. I like that hat. So we're going to be talking to Mark here in just a second, but I wanted to tell you, if you have any questions, please post them up, and we'll be going through some of the questions and answering them when we're done. I've got a bunch of questions for him, and hopefully those questions will help you. Mark is, I think, loving this, at least from all the evidence I've seen, he's loving this business. He told me he had two things to do. He had to clean and count money. So I'm going to bring Mark on here real quick. Mark, thank you for joining us.
Well, hello, Ben, and hello, street food vendors across the fruited plain.
So Mark, tell me something. I'm going to go ahead and just dive into questions, and that'll probably inspire six other questions, because both of us are pretty Southerner boys.
Yeah.
I mean, you're a little tad Southerner than me, being in Alabama, but I want to ask you, how long have you been vending? When did you get started?
Well, I have been legal and full time since July of last year. Before that, I've been a weekend warrior, you know, cooking here and there, doing this and that, but decided in July, because hey, we're the Great American Hot Dog Stand. July is when we kicked off full time.
So, and you started full time in July, as far as that's what you're not a part time vendor. You work full time.
Do it full time, baby. Six days a week.
I love it. 6 days a week.
Yeah, I take Sundays off. Everybody's got to have one day of rest.
I know, but 6 days a week. That's a lot of vending. What kind of hours are you doing a day?
Well, typically the typical day for me, on the street is 11 to 2.
Okay.
But as all of you guys know, it ain't 11 to 2. But I've got a unique situation down here. We, in my little bitty town here, we don't have any foot traffic. So I'm having to get folks in off the road.
Okay. Okay. So you're having to, you've created some, unique marketing things to bring them actually to you. They're not walking by you.
No, they're not.
And that is a harder thing to do. It is a way harder. That's how I started, trying to pull over 60 mile an hour traffic, you know, and without a pullover, you know, without a pullout spot, and get them onto the side of the road, and or to go up like, you know, three blocks and come down an access road to me to a tire shop is where I started in front of. But right. it didn't have direct highway access. So next question for you. What inspired this, Mark? What inspired you?
Well, it's a long story to make it even longer. Probably about 6 years ago, I was in between jobs and saw, and it wasn't you, it was another guy. Don't get your feelings hurt. I didn't even know about you till recently. And so I built a hot dog cart and said, oh yeah, this makes sense. The money's going to start just falling out of the sky. And right. So I built the hot dog cart and started wading through the process. I did all my due diligence. But at the time, the health department was mobile food hostile.
Right.
And through a long, it was just it was just crazy. And I didn't know how to deal with the health inspectors. And so finally, after fighting them for a while, I just said the heck with it and went and got a real job. And that hot dog cart, I pulled it out every once in a while, used it, but it stayed in the basement. Then I said to myself, I need to sell it or do something with it. And I put it on Craigslist and didn't really sometimes get some interest and not. And finally, I just said, you know what? I'm going to sell this thing for $2,000. I think that's just a Band-Aid. Why don't I just go sell hot dogs? Because I know hot dogs. I know how to do it. I know what the deal is. And I can learn how to be friendly and talk to folks and be outgoing, because, you know, I'm kind of introverted and shy. And so I just decided, heck, let's do it. and did it. And here we are. I'm getting interviewed on I Love Street Food Vending.
So you got going and you decided to go full time. And are you doing any catering and stuff too? Like we've been, I know the answer to this already. So don't think it's a redundant question. There's people listening that don't know, but do you do catering events, any other little things like that?
Oh yeah. Matter of fact, right now our business plan is if it'll make a little bit of money, we'll do it if it's not illegal and immoral. So I'm doing catering. Most of my catering stuff, though, is with businesses.
Right.
In other words, the business wants to feed their employees or they want to do a hot dog giveaway to their customers. That's one of the plans for this year is to up that catering, hopefully by 10% is my goal. Really, we need to go about 20 or 25%. But to give you a for instance and how this is working for me here with a small hot dog cart, I have a liquor distributor here that's local. And once a week or once a month, they do inventory. And because of one of the spots I was sitting at, they happened to drive by all the time. And they said, hey, can you come feed the employees one day? And I says, right. Well, yeah, how often do you do this? He's like, every month. And I'm like, well, dude, I can do spaghetti. I can do tacos. I can do ribeyes. You got the money. I got the time.
And that'd be a good name of a song.
Right? And guys, if you've got a hot dog cart and if you're just doing hot dogs, let me tell you what I did. This Friday was my very first spaghetti lunch that I did. And I went in there and did this spaghetti lunch. They were so impressed with just spaghetti that I got a gig with them tomorrow night and they want me back next Friday to do hot dogs. And so I don't know. Spaghetti's pretty easy once you figure out what you got to do.
Right. Spaghetti is fun. Bread. I mean, I've even done the bread with the spaghetti. The first time I made it too soggy. You know, I put it in the steam table and it got soggy as heck. I was using French loaves that I bought, big long loaves. But then I learned how to manage that. And it's awesome to do. You got a couple questions. Somebody says, I'm traveling around. I'm going to put this up on the screen. I'm traveling around to large events all over the country. Do you do any large festivals?
Yeah. Well, I don't know what you call large. We've done a couple that's had, I don't know, a whole bunch of people at them. But here's the deal. Yeah, I do them. It doesn't matter to me how much, because here's what I do. I figure out either how many hot dogs can I afford to take or how many do I need to take? And I just go. And let's just say like this last weekend, we had our first event of the year because, well, it's February. And I don't know, we had 300, 400 hot dogs. And that's all it took because it was supposed to rain. And I just said, we're not going to spend any more money. I think we can sell those. And we sold out. It went from 11 till 5. We were sold out by 1:30. And I says, I'm cool with that.
Yeah.
You know,
I've had people call me. I had a lady call me. I've had a lot of people call me complaining about this, about running out. But one lady called me and she was crying, Mark. She was crying because she had run out and she goes, I could have made another $1,000. And I basically said, shoulda, coulda, woulda. I'm in the camp of play it safe.
Right.
Take what you can afford that wouldn't hurt you a bit if you had to take it all home.
Right.
Okay. If the flood came and Noah's Ark came by and you had to take it all back to the house, I don't want to get you hurt. So I don't try to preach, hey, take the risk. I say, don't take the risk until you have risk money to risk.
That's the key. And we don't have the money to risk. So, you know, I'm okay with selling out. Sell out, pack up, go home, count the money.
Right. Right. So I'm going to put this up here. Just cause I like that. The no risk method. So what in your, you've been doing this in July will be your anniversary. your 1 year anniversary mark, a full time vending. So you're 3/4 of a year through it, pretty much.
Right.
What is, what would you say you love the most about the business? What have you noticed that you went, oh my gosh, or is there an oh my gosh?
What do I love the most about street food vending? I like just dealing with the people. And I also like the fact that I don't have a boss other than the wife looking over my shoulder saying, hey, did you finish the TPS reports? Did you get the cover on those TPS reports? And I, I'm just not the kind of guy to sit in an office somewhere, and I'm too old and broke down to dig ditches. And so, I'm not one to be sensational about stuff. It's just one of those things that just kind of fits with my, it just kind of fits with me. Right. So there's not just one thing I like about it. I like it when the sun shines and it's above 55 degrees.
Well, tell me this. Here's what I hear from a lot of vendors, and I don't want to put words in your mouth. And the biggest thing I noticed immediately, and if anybody's heard my story, I'm not going to go through it today. I was almost divorced. I mean, literally almost divorced, not because I couldn't take care of my family, but because I was never home when I had the furniture stores. And then, and when I lost all that, I was home a lot, even vending. I was home a lot. And I did like you, Mark. There was weeks I did 7 days a week, and some I did 6 days a week. And I was just nose to the grind type deal, but still, it was nothing like the 15, 16 hour days at the furniture stores and constantly out of state because I had stores in different states. So, I wrote an article once called Hot Dog Saved My Marriage. My book's called Hot Dog Saved My Life, but it saved all of it. I got to watch my kids. So what I was asking there, long story to get around to that is, do you have more time now? Do you have time with family?
Oh yeah, most definitely. I mean, if we need to go do something, we just go do it.
And tell me this, Mark, you're scheduled to work tomorrow, right?
Tomorrow night. It's probably going to rain tomorrow. So we're just tomorrow night.
But let's say something came up, your mother-in-law got sick or your daughter needed help at a ball game to help do something. Could you just not go?
I just would go take care of what I need to take care of.
Do you have to call anybody and get permission or write an excuse or get a doctor's note?
No, sir. Because I'm a grown darn man running my own company.
I love that. That's my favorite part is freedom. And freedom.
Freedom!
So, Wes Harris says, so excited to get started. Antonio says, I've done Mardi Gras and Burning Man now. William Joseph says, that's cool. Darube says, you sell spaghetti under hot dog cart license? Well, yeah. Darube, if you follow us, I've been talking only for about 3 years on this. You can sell anything you want from your cart, catering. Okay. That's why I've told everybody to change their name to such and such hot dog cart and catering and add catering to stuff that you advertise and promote. You can do anything you want catering in all 50 states. You can do so much more. I just did a free masterclass. It's the first time I've ever done one free, and it's still available. If you can't find it, email me, Ben@VendorsUnited.com. Send it to Ben@VendorsUnited.com. I'll send you the link. You can watch it free. It's fixing to come down, though, and then it won't be free anymore because it's an entire class, an hour and a half of me giving you all the specifics on doing just that. You're going to get a lot of information, tons. William says, better to run out and make money.
Yeah.
Better to run out of supplies and have made money than to risk money that could risk your business or risk your sanity.
Yeah. Here's one thing I will say about that. There's going to come a time when you do an event and you're getting ready to run out and you're going to be tempted Like, we had a Piggly Wiggly just down the road from us Saturday. Could have gone down there and spent another 100, 200 bucks or 300. Could have spent whatever. I actually had to resist the urge and just tell myself, oh, we're good. Sell out and be good. Be good. Don't need to go get nothing. So it's going to take that first time it happens. It's going to take a little bit of inner discipline, not right. to run off and try to make it, you know. Yeah, well, there you go.
So Antonio asked, Mark, what's your favorite dog to use?
Well, my favorite is an all beef brat from Johnsonville. Now, what's working on the cart is an all beef Nathan's hot dog.
You make
with
a good
the exception,
point.
With the exception, mm-hmm. is I just started carrying, and if you're in the South, you know this. If you're not in the Southeast, these words won't make any sense to you. But Ziegler Meats, the tradition of great taste, they I just recently started carrying their Southern style smoked sausage. They're trying to compete with Konecka, by the way. I just started carrying it, and some days it outsells the all beef hot dogs. Blows my mind.
That's why we do taste tests. That's why we teach to do taste tests, because it doesn't matter what your favorite is. You could have moved from New Jersey or had a mom from West LA who liked a certain thing that you fell in love with. It doesn't mean anything if you're in Missouri, okay, or if you're in Chicago. You better be serving Vienna if you're in Chicago. You better be serving what's the majority eats in your area. I can serve right here in East Tennessee, ballpark. I can serve Oscar Mayer, all beef. All of them are all beef. Or I can serve Nathan's or the no-name brand Nathan's from Sam's Club. And either way, everybody loves it. So we did taste tests, and I teach you how to do that. Just do a taste test, friends and neighbors. Go do something for your family or for your church or for a community, like a community charity. Maybe for the SPCA, you show up and do it, but do it as a taste test. You'll get unbiased opinions, because if they can try everything for free, they're going to tell you the truth what they like better.
Yeah, I do that for my pricing as well. I usually ask the folks at church, hey, if I charge $3 for this, would you buy it? And so they're like, no. And I'm like, oh, I better lower my prices then. You know, church folks are pretty cheap.
Right.
Hey, Ben, remind me to ask something about that Ziegler thing and the way that came up. Might be right. interesting for somebody if you get time later on in the interview.
Okay. Okay. What would you do different now that you've been doing it and you went through the process, Mark? What would you do differently, and what advice would you give to someone, okay, who has just starting out or thinking about starting out? What would you tell them?
I'm trying to think of something that I would do different, and hopefully I haven't made too many mistakes that I would change. I would set up my cart differently. 100%. I'd have a bigger cart. That's probably the only thing that I would do differently. Cause I built my cart. One day when I make enough money, I'm going to buy me one of those sleek, sexy Cater Pros, baby. Or that doggone Stand King. I am trying not to covet that thing. Cause Big Daddy likes not being out in the elements. Now, what I would tell you, if you're going to get started, and I didn't fall into this trap, but it seems like I see a lot of people doing it, not doing their homework, not knowing how to deal with the health department, not knowing how to deal with your municipalities. Do your homework, know what you need to know before you go. That's probably the biggest tip that I can give you, because I mean, really, we could train a gorilla to hand out hot dogs. I mean, we sent monkeys into space, Ben.
Yeah, I know.
So that's the easy part. The hard part is dealing with the health departments and the biggest problem I have is with municipalities, at first, and then those things tend to start easing up and working out.
And once you get through it, you're good to go. You're good to go.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of the way it is in this small town that I'm in now. And the small town I was in Saturday, that was a problem city until last week. And I was able to solve that, score that deal on Saturday, and we'll be over there vending in that city probably next week or the week after. And that's where the county courthouse is.
Darube wants to know the name of that dog again, that brand, the brought.
Well, it's a Johnsonville brought.
Yeah, but there was a different one I think you mentioned.
Oh, Ziegler.
Ziegler. Okay, I'm going to put that up.
Ziegler. Now, here's the deal. I have talked with them because I'm not saying I'm the Ziegler spokesman, but they are allowing me to plug their product. If you're interested in doing Ziegler's, you need to get in touch with me because I've got the hookup. I don't know what the pricing is going to be yet. They don't either, but it's not going to be retail pricing. Because when they made the deal with me, I'd ask them, hey, I'm in this Facebook group, and if I tell everybody that this is available in the Southeast, y'all need to be ready to take a phone call, at least one or two,
right,
to let vendors know, because there might be an opportunity there. I haven't made the announcement. I guess I just did, actually. tomorrow we were going to make the big announcement to all of our customers that we're now carrying Ziegler and it's on the menu. And then I was going to announce it in the Street Food Pro
group
and see if anybody in the South wanted to at least contact these guys. Because if you're doing a smoked sausage, it's really good. And that whole Ziegler story, the way that came about, is pretty awesome. By the way, guys, tighten up your Facebook pages. It worked out for me.
If you have a way of getting up with them, Ziegler, if you have an in there, let them know. We'll have them on the show. We'll talk about their startup, how they got started, and maybe we can maybe I'll buy some cases and send it out to different vendors to try.
Yeah, I do kind of have an in. Now, Ziegler's been around for 75 plus years.
Right.
I don't know any of you folks follow college football, but one of the greatest coaches in college football was the late, great Paul William Bear Bryant. And the Bear used to be part owner of Ziegler. So, of course, if you're That's an cool. Auburn fan, if you're an Auburn fan, you don't like that too much, but hey.
Hey, Antonio asks, he says, LOL, I couldn't resist. I was at a Chili event and the only vendor there, I sold out three times that day and had my daughter running back and forth to the store and had a line all day.
Right on, Antonio.
Yeah, I know that feeling. I, when I started out, I didn't have a pot to piss in or a window to throw it out of. And so when we set up with two packs of hot dogs. I had 16 hot dogs. That's it. Right.
And run.
So my wife is there with me and we're in a borrowed car. We had lost our cars and everything. And so I'm every time I'd get down to three or four dogs, she'd run down to Food City, grab a couple of bags, Oscar Mayer, come back. Yeah. It was that way for 2 days. We did it that way. We ran it just by the seat of our pants because we didn't have the money.
I feel you, brother.
And all that changed, it all changed, but it was a sacrifice at the time. And to me, it was embarrassing, right. The second day I was there and I had set up an hour early. I didn't know the times to set up or any of that stuff yet. And I'd set up an hour early just to see what would happen. Well, it happened. Well, my wife hadn't gotten there yet. So I ran out of hot dogs. So I'm running down the street, getting my little signs, picking them up. And then I asked the tire company if I could push my cart inside their freaking warehouse so that nobody would stop. Cause I was scared to death. I was going to tell somebody I didn't have any dang hot dogs. And at the time, this is funny, Mark, but at the time me and we didn't have nothing. I'm telling you, food stamps. We were on food stamps. And my wife is, we don't have a cell phone, so I can't even call her. I can't even call her and say, hurry up. I knew she'd be there at 11. Here I am there at 10. And by 10:30, I'm out of hot dogs. But I only started with like 24. Right. So I run through 24 hot dogs in 30 minutes, which is great. But it wasn't great. I was more embarrassed than anything. All right, we got more here. Let's see. It's the way to go, and for the money you can't beat it. That's Stan King. He's talking about the Stan King. Somebody asked a question. I use Hillshire Farms 100% beef smoked sausage, and my people love it. Excellent for you. Always go with what the people love. It doesn't matter what I tell you or Mark tells you. What's the best dog? I have a best dog. In fact, I'd put money on it's one of the best dogs, Boar's Head. And I know they've got a big name, and they charge you $2 a hot dog wholesale.
Yeah.
But I also don't offer that on my cart, but it is a fantastic freaking hot dog. They make a good dog. If I was selling $9 gourmet dogs, I might consider it, but I'm not. Let's see. Bacon and cheese hot dogs. Yes. I did a show the other day in the members area about injecting your dogs, and I put it on the blog, injecting your dogs. I even told you the injector. I've went through 20-something injectors. I know which injector works, and it's cheap, okay? You don't spend a lot of money on it. It's on the blog. You inject that dog with, I put actually bacon, cheese, and garlic and a little butter. So it's a heart attack dog when you get done with it. I don't do a lot of it. I may make 20 of them up the day before or that morning when I'm setting up. And then when I'm out, I'm out. But people pay $3 extra for that stupid dog because it's got bacon and cheese and garlic in it.
Bacon is meat candy.
Oh, it's I could live on it. William says, testify, Ben, testify.
I just saw a question right there.
Yeah.
I don't know. Jeremy, I think, asked the question.
I got it up on the screen now. Do you steam or boil?
All right, babe, here's how. Let me just tell you, if there's a way to cook a hot dog, I've done it. I'll wrap one up in tinfoil, sit it up on the exhaust if I have to. But I started out as a steamer. Mm-hmm. I just started out steaming, and had a problem holding for long. And I had a problem guessing because I don't guess right. And so here's what I'm doing now. It's a dirty water dog, but we don't call them that down here because nobody knows what the heck that is.
They don't have a clue.
So what I'm doing is now I am boiling and get, I don't know, 20, 30 of those rascals up in there and get them up temp, turn it off. And I've been doing it for the last, I don't know, it's only been probably 3 weeks now that I've been doing that, Ben. And it had an unintended consequence that I didn't think about. It's saving me propane rather than running my eyes all the time.
It is the best. I've done videos on it, Mark. You know it.
And
we've got a vendor in the group that's down in Florida near the Suwannee River, and he calls his the Suwannee River dog.
There you go, baby.
His water is the Suwannee Water Dog. Suwannee Water Dog.
That's right.
And so you could do your river water dog or whatever you wanted. But, yeah, absolutely. It makes more sense. You boil them for a little while, turn it off. It'll stay at 140 or above for longer than you. If you have hot dogs left after 2 hours, like you've boiled them, and you're sitting there still with hot dogs, you probably need to find a new location or change your signs or something. Something's wrong. Right. But they do have longevity. There's bad days. There's rain clouds. Stuff happens. And you don't know. You might have just boiled 40 dogs and gone, oh, crap, it's fixing to rain. Well, the nice part is they don't ruin. They don't ruin there. Where steaming, grilling, they ruin.
Yeah, I do finish them off on a grill when we have time. But, you know, if I got folks standing in line, give me that money. Here's your dog. Have a great day. Enjoy your great American hot dogs.
William says he used bouillon paste, steak seasoning, and to make his dirty water dog. I've got, you know, I was getting free beer from my beer guy. I've got it in my course book. Hot Dog Saved My Life. I got the beer guy would give me free beer that they had to throw away. He has to actually throw it away. I could use that as long as I wasn't selling it, right? So he'd give me a case of beer. Well, I don't need that much beer. And I would just pour a can in there and get my water started and throw a couple bouillon cubes. Now, I did a Mexican feast for a charity. It was a church deal. Their church had burned down, or half of it had burned down. And it was a, you know, a Latino church, Hispanic church or whatever. And I went and did that to help them raise money. And I put cayenne peppers in there, threw some couple green peppers in there, but I split them first so that they seeped out flavors, threw a couple garlic cloves and two Coronas.
Boom. That's right. That's what I'm talking about. You just figure it out. You figure out what tastes good and just roll with it.
And I'll throw, if somebody says, hey, will you throw it up on the grill? Because I've always had a big dog with the grill up on top to the left. I'll throw one up there, split it, throw it up there for 2 seconds. It smells good. If I'm not real busy, I do it every now and then anyway. I definitely do it to all my sausages. I don't sell as many sausages as I do hot dogs. So hot dogs, I'm just constantly serving if it's busy. And then every now and then somebody will say, hey, can you grill that real quick? And I'll go and throw it up on the grill. So
right on.
It really doesn't change the flavor. I mean, it might caramelize some of the sugars that are in the meat, but not enough for me to write a book about. Let's see. Here's a question from Christopher. Thanks for joining us, Christopher. Have you ever done a deep fry hot dog? Yes. We call them rippers, I think.
I ain't fooling with the old deep fry, baby.
No. Well, on a cart is a nightmare, having grease. Right. Okay. Yeah. A nightmare. I don't recommend it. Y'all have heard me say it for years. If you've heard me, you've heard me say that. But in a trailer or restaurant, Ripper Dogs are awesome. They taste good. My wife freaking loves Ripper Dogs. It's where they call them rippers. I didn't come up with that name. When you fry them, they bust apart and rip open, and they fry along the edges of the rip and get crispy. And my wife likes crispy. She likes her steak black, you know, where it's leather. And I'm not that way. I like things, you know, softer, but the Ripper Dog is a good dog. It's a delicious hot dog. And so, yeah.
You can deep fry just about anything, Ben, and it'd be good for Southern folk.
Oh yeah. I've deep fried it. I mean, I grew up eating chitlins, so that tells you.
Hey, stomp whooper, creep flung.
Always offer a very high price dog. Some people have to buy it. Great point, Garrett. That's a great point.
It is.
I always have one unique item. Corey taught me this. He always changes it up. I always had the same thing. Okay. Corey changes his up. Like the other day, he had macaroni and cheese on a dog. I think it had bacon on it. I know it had barbecue. That's what it had. It had a little barbecue or barbecue sauce and some baked beans. I looked at the picture and drooled on my screen. Unbelievable. But Garrett, that's a great point.
Yeah.
Owen says, wrap it in bacon and fry it. Yeah, I've done it. In fact, there's a video on my YouTube of me doing that. I agree. They like the texture. Neil says they like the texture of that. Can you elaborate on catering? Can you sell spaghetti at your everyday spot where you can get random customers because you're catering in the name? No, that ain't catering. It's a slippery slope, to say the least. Here's what you do. If a car lot calls you, if the church calls you, or the doctor's office, or the bank, and they're doing an employee day or whatever, that's catering. You're going to somebody. I just sent out a cart Sunday. Somebody picked it up, took it up to Greenbrier in the mountains. That's catering, but they took it. I made the food. They took it up there. They can eat whatever they want. It'd just be like taking a grill up into the mountains and eating it at the state park. They took it to the state park, Greenbrier State Park, National Park, and they went in there with their hot dog cart, pulling it behind a Honda Civic. Or maybe it was an Accord. They pulled it right up there. And they did their little thing. You can do that. Catering, even if you went, you can do it because it's private. It's a private meal. It's not serving to the public. Your health codes, even though it covers some catering, it doesn't. What it typically is about is Fifth and Main. You know, like Mark going out to the in front of Advance Auto Parts or in front of Walmart. That street food vending and hot dogs is pretty much it there, except in a, you know, with slight variations. Let's see. I'm going back through the questions real quick. Garrett says, yeah, you can get 2 to 3 extra euros by having a specialty dog each day.
I hope nobody gives me any euros.
My high priced dog is the barbecue coleslaw dog with cream cheese. I love cream cheese. It's like magic. And if you're in the Vendors United group with us, I posted up a video. I've never shared my recipe, okay, with anyone ever. And yeah, I put it up to the members area yesterday. Actually showed me making it. I'm not great on camera, but I had my wife hold the camera in our kitchen. I was getting, somebody was Skyping me. I forgot to turn it off. I'll do that now. Otherwise it'll keep happening. Anyway, she shows me making it. I give you the ingredient list, everything. Check it out. It may not be your cup of tea. It is dynamite. Let's see. What if the food is prepared at the commissary? Yes, some states and most states will allow you to serve anything from a cart if it's prepared at the commissary, but it also has to be already prepackaged in individual servings. That's where it gets a pain in the neck. Now, I just did an article yesterday for the street food pro team about the brownies, and you can put that stuff in there. And, you know, I do the big brownies, the real big ones, so I can get $4 a piece out of them. And I pre-wrap those because all I do is stick them in my cart. You know, I don't even take a lot of them. But I can get $4 out of those, where before for three, I'd get $3. Now, I was getting $1 a piece for these little ones, right? And I figured out that I could get more money by giving one that's about three times one, and I make an extra dollar. Somebody says, howdy y'all. David says, howdy y'all. Mark says, hot dog splitter, it cuts the hot dogs. Yes, we have that in the, it's on our Facebook page. We don't sell it, but we give you a link. Plus in the resources page, Amazon has them, the little spiral cutters and the straight cutters. Garrett says, I'm loving this. I've been a trader for 25 years in Dublin, Ireland. My wife is Irish. I know a lot of people say they're Irish. They did a survey about how many people say they're Irish. And it's like 60% of the population. And it's actually not that, as far as not that many people are Irish.
Yeah, I'm not Irish.
I'm really not. I'm not Irish. My wife is Irish, like 62%. Dublin, Ireland. Garrett, thanks for joining us. Love this business, Monster Burgers in Dublin. Hey, Garrett, message me or message the page here with your link to your page on Facebook, and I'll share it with everybody. I'd like to connect with you anyway. I think it's cool. I'd like to interview you. Jason Summer says, bacon wrap, deep fried smoked sausage. Heck yeah, sounds good. We've got a vendor that has made a fortune in the last 4 years doing a breakfast. He showed up early. Let me give you the short story, Mark. He showed up early to his job. People asked him if he had coffee. He goes, no, but a bell went off in his head, and he said, oh, I'm going to start serving coffee. He's near a bunch of office complexes, but he's also near this courthouse annex building. And he came on the show and he's telling us the story. He ended up getting those AirPods and doing coffee, right? But then he didn't know what kind of dog do you serve with it. Breakfast brats. They have them. They have bacon cheddar breakfast brats. They have maple bacon breakfast brats. They got sausage maple bacon breakfast brats. Jalapeno bacon breakfast brats. They got them all. He has made a fortune. The dude went from here, just, you know, your average vendor, to booyah. I think he's got, I don't know how many carts he has now, but he's bought at least 10 for me.
Maybe I need to learn how to get up earlier and try some of that breakfast stuff.
Nobody's doing it. That's the thing. That's what's unique. Plus he started with coffee. He didn't even take food the first day. Just no food. Just took off. Well, he took his food, but he didn't turn on his steam tables or nothing until 11:30 or 11. He was on our show. What is the page? The page to what? VendorsUnited.com is the, if you're talking about Vendors United, Facebook, we're on the page. How do you manage prep time before an event? That's tricky. It is.
Well,
Mark?
For me, it's pretty as well. It's going to take a little bit more. You got to go to the store and get your stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you live in the, you know, if you live in the middle of BF Egypt, then it's going to take you a long time. However long it takes you to get to the store. I mean, your pans should already be ready. So, because I kind of do an event the same way I do my street side stuff with the addition of some people. All I've got is extra people. So we're just talking about more product. But as far as prep goes, it doesn't really take all that much more time. You just really need to use your checklist good because you can't leave anything at the house or at the commissary.
And I believe Mark, that we have a checklist over on in the, I know we do in Vendors United group, but I think there's also one at the Learn Hot Dog site for free.
Yep.
And I think there that it was given to us by Doug's Dogs out of Georgia.
I took it and changed it, and that's what I'm using.
That's the way to do it.
So thanks, Ben. Appreciate it.
Yeah, yeah. Garrett says, I'm looking forward to doing loads of business with you guys. I have family in Louisiana, and I'm going to open there soon.
Play awesome. My song.
Awesome. Awesome. I've got family in Louisiana, too. I love Louisiana. It's a cool place.
I've got a couple of customers from Louisiana, and they like the sausage.
Neil's looking for Facebook pages, I think, for you.
Oh.
That's what he's looking for.
Well, here you go to facebook.com/Great American Hot Dog Stand.
I'm going to put it in there. Let's see. Great. Let's see. Facebook.com. It's not the great. Great.
No, just great.
American Hot Dog Art Stand.
Hot Dog Stand.
Hot Dog Stand.
Great American Hot Dog Stand.
I grabbed a picture off there today for your little icon on here.
Yeah, so, I noticed that.
It was just your most recent video. I love your videos. If y'all want to follow somebody cool, he does some cool videos and shows you stuff. And he's just real. Mark's real.
Mark, that's a funny thing. Yeah, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
Well, I was going to say, guys, if you look at my Facebook and you see those silly little videos, I just want you to know that that's making me some money now. The president of Ziegler Meats saw those ads on Facebook and asked his folks, you need to find that guy, see if he'll tote some of our product. And they contacted me, and I kind of blew them off because it was a pork product and I don't dig the pig. And they just kept on. And finally I said, okay, let's get together and talk about it. And I think 2 weekends ago, I sat down and met with them. We talked about availability and price and some other and some support for sales and the fact that I would plug them a little bit. And so now I've got a new product on the cart at that's a good product. People love it, and I'm not paying an arm and a leg for it. So well, the video has worked.
Yeah. Well, we've been pushing more Facebook, you know, talking about that even in the group. We just did an article. Heather got it up last week about Facebook and about the key things you need to be doing, more so than a website.
Right.
Mark, what advice before we go, what advice would you give to others? I know I already asked you this, but I don't remember your answer. Did you answer me? What advice would you give to someone new starting out what to do?
The very first thing is you need to do your homework. You need to know what your health regulations are. You don't need to guess. And you need to know your municipalities and what you got to do and who you need to know and who you need to talk to. Don't assume. Spell it out. Put the little lines in it. You know what happens when you assume. And I've even assumed myself and been wrong. And so do your homework. Know what the rules are. If you don't know what the rules are, call somebody and ask them. And then after that, get out there and just do a quality product and treat people right. And there you go.
I like that. My other thing, do your due diligence. You brought this up earlier. That's what you brought up earlier too. You brought up doing your research first, but due diligence, you know, do your due diligence. Somebody asked real quick, and we're going to take a couple more questions, then we're going to go. Is there any way to sell grill hot dogs on your cart to the public that will pass the California health code? Absolutely. There's people that are doing it. Usually they require some kind of cover on it. In fact, we had a guy come on our show and talk about it, actually show his cart. He used my cart, but he used one he built. He went to buildacart.com, and he built a cart, but he made it 900 times more cool than mine. Okay. He just took mine as the basis for it. And he showed his whole build in 700 pictures that are on our website. 700 pictures. A video, even filmed his health inspection live. So we have all that there for you. It's free at learnhotdogs.com. That's on the board right here too. And you can also, if you want to get updates from me, I don't do a lot of this, but I do some of it. Something important I'll send you. If you text the word street food, as one word, street food, to 292929, you'll get an instant response. If you don't get an instant response, you didn't do it right. And you'll be on my list, okay? And not in a bad way. You're on the good people list. Mark says he appreciates everyone out there. William says he sells advertising on his cart. Me too.
Yeah, there you go.
Wes says, thank you so much for the great information. Wes, thank you for the compliment and the kind words. Dave says, thank you for the great interview. Thanks for sharing. Jeremy says, I'm going to try and set up at a bridge construction site this week. It's out of town, but close to me. Your thoughts? Abso-freaking-lutely. I just had a vendor call me. He's in the in North Carolina on the islands. And they're building a new bridge to replace a really, really old bridge. And he's kicking butt. Let's see. He's just got a cash cow too. Little bitty cash cow, and he's kicking butt. Michael Woods told me to plan the work the plan.
Amen.
Great advice. Business plan is the roadmap and compass, a must, Neil says. Make a business plan, William says. I love y'all. Lonnie says, thank you. Irving says, no cart, no biz, no exceptions. Neil says, thanks, guys. I appreciate it, Neil. Yes, Garrett, nowadays, credit card sales are vital. I keep an app now, and I hate it. I hate even having to do that, the little dongle thing on my phone, and have somebody take my phone and write their name, you know, or check boxes or put in a tip. But it's a must. Most people that are doing enough, I don't do enough to warrant this, but most people that are doing enough, get them an iPad and do it. You know, they have an iPad for the customer, and that's the only software on it. It's the Square or the PayPal or the Intuit QuickBooks one, or there's about a blue million of them.
So that's coming from me.
Yeah. It's something. I may give one of those away soon. That's a good idea. Give a freaking iPad away, you know, some kind of pad.
We froze it.
Jason's done a course on it. I've done a thing on it. Somebody says, do you eat fruit from time to time? This must be just a fake. Yeah.
I don't eat any fruit.
No, that's some moron spammer crap.
Hey, vegetables aren't food.
No.
That's what food is.
Yeah. 50, Garrett says 50 per month. Yeah. Alex Streeter. Yes. Alexa Streeter. I said Alex again. I did that to her the other day. Floating cart, better on a poor people lake or rich people lake? I have done better. Now I have to be completely honest. I've not done it floating. Okay. I have done it, but I didn't do it with my cart and set up. I did it with another vendor. I have vendors that I've taught that are on pontoon boats. I will tell you this, on the more normal people lakes, the fishing in a John boat with your 1934 Evinrude that smokes like a cob, and you ain't going to fix it because you don't have mosquito problems when it's running. That kind of lake, that one you'll kick butt on. I have set up at the boat ramps at lakes and made a fortune. I've got it in my book. I have made a fortune at the boat ramps.
I'm fixing to be lake. Doing one of those, Ben.
You're fixing to do the boat ramp, or are you doing a lake on a boat?
No, well, the lake on the pontoon boat is within a 2-year thing, but we're going to be doing one of the public launches. And so once the water temperature gets 60 and the temperature is enough, I'm going to be out there on the old boat ramp.
I may have misjudged Lee Merck. He said he sells fruit. He distributes frozen fruit, I guess, to people that want fruit. Now, we have some vendors doing all natural vegan carts and tofu carts and cardboard shaped like hot dogs with ketchup. But I don't, Lee, I'm sorry if I offended you, but people, I'm not removing your post. It'll stay there. And if anybody has a healthy cart, we have Mark. There's a guy. We have a guy named Mark. He has a cart called Fresh For You. And he sells fresh foods and fresh stuff off his cart. He does a phenomenal job. He's been doing it 4 or 5 years now. And I may have lied. It may be like 6 or 7 years. It's just my memory's fading.
That's pretty cool.
Mark says hot dogs saved my life. Mine too, Mark. In fact, that's Mark. Mark, that's Mark right there, Fresh For You. Am I right, yep. Mark? I hope I'm right. I think I am. I know that's Mark. There you go. They picked up the pontoon Saturday, going to build a wheelless cart on the deck. Absolutely, Tony. Kick butt. Please send us pictures. We'll share them with everybody. You'll do fantastic on a boat, and you can get a license to do alcohol on a boat.
You're not in Alabama, are you, Tony? Central Alabama here.
That's right. Me and Mark will be over there.
Oh, hey Ben. Evidently, we're inspiring people down here where we're at, because we've already had, I got 4 or 5 people that want to start a hot dog stand. There's a guy that just started a trailer 4 blocks down from me.
I was right, Mark. Mark Robinson, it is Fresh For You. I was just bragging about you, Mark, and he does good whole. He's got some wholesome menu items, rabbit food stuff. I am a hillbilly, still eat crap, but I have lost weight. Y'all can tell, and I had to eat more healthy to do that, so I'm not completely against it. But I'm just mostly making fun, Mark. It's happened to me too, that where people, they see you doing working, and they go, oh my gosh, this has got to be easy. I could probably watch Oprah all day and just buy a cart and make money. And I never worry about that stuff, but it is cool that it inspires people, because there's enough room for everybody. You drive through even your little town, Mark, and how many gas stations do you see?
Yeah, you can't sling a dead cat without hitting one.
Right. And they all stay in business. They're not struggling. So my point is that it's rare you see a gas station go out of business. And usually only just to put in a bigger one. So I wouldn't worry about competition. I never have. It's never bothered me. I've trained some of my own competition. I've trained some of my own competition where they came to me and said, hey, Ben, I'm in Knoxville. Would you let me work with you for a day? And they work with me. And then the next thing I know, they're 2 blocks down the road from me. I've had that happen. I don't care.
Right.
There's plenty. I can't serve every hot dog that needs served that day.
That's right. It's America, baby. Start a business.
That's right. I'm all for that. I thank y'all for joining us. Mark, I want to thank you for coming out and giving us this much time. This has almost been an hour. Longest interview yet. And I appreciate you giving of your time. I know you work hard, and I appreciate it. I love your sense of humor, and I love the fact that you post up videos on your Facebook page, and I'm thankful you're a part of the Vendors United group because you're an asset. So thank you for being here.
Well, thank you for having me, Ben. It's been good.
I enjoyed it. I'll get down to Alabama and we'll hook up.
Oh yeah, you got to come down. It's not far.
Oh, we'll have a blast. Go ahead, Mark.
No, I was going to say if Sevierville hadn't burned to the ground, we could come up there, go vacation, and stop by the hot dog cart store, check out everything.
For real, it's burned to the ground. Half that dang Gatlinburg's gone. If you want, I just put up on the middle of the screen, learnhotdogs.com. It's a free website. I've been working on that for years, nine roughly. And I post stuff almost daily there. Mark knows it. I work hard on it. There's over 500 videos. There's over 900 or 1,000 articles. Not that you need to read them all. Some of them will bore you to tears and you'll wish you had just chewed through a pine tree or something. But because I'm not that entertaining, but if you are looking for a specific item, hit the search box, find that item, not like to buy. I'm saying, I want to know more about catering, or I want to know about more about bacon, whatever it is. You put the keyword in, it'll pull up the articles that I've done on it, or that we've done on it, collectively done on it. I thank y'all all. I love you. And I thank you for being here. Mark, again, thank you.
Ben, I just want to say thank you because you've been a huge asset to me. And everything that's on I love hot dogs.
Learnhotdogs.com, and I love hot dog vending.
Yep. It's been a huge asset for me.
Well, I thank you, Mark. I appreciate it. I hope y'all have a wonderful day, and we'll see you tomorrow. We're interviewing another vendor. So yeah. We're just going to be interviewing vendors.
Right on, baby. Deuces.
See y'all later. Y'all have a good one.
All right. Bye. Bye-bye.